We'll see how crazy this is.
Okay. So you're in a cool room right now. Where are you?
This is my studio. Mm-hmm. It's a disaster. So.
Oh, that's all right. You live in Georgia?
Well, in all honesty, I'm back and forth. My family is in North Carolina, which is where I am right now.
Where are you in North Carolina? I went to school in North Carolina.
You did?
I did.
Wow.
Yeah, I spent about 6 years in North Carolina.
Okay. No, I'm in Fayetteville.
Oh, you're in Fayetteville. Okay. I went to school in Raleigh, and then I worked in what's the town next to Raleigh?
Durham? Chapel Hill?
No.
Cary.
Cary, yeah. So I had to commute from Raleigh to Cary at like 4 in the morning because I worked in a hotel. It was terrible. And I drove a Jeep and then the gas was like insane.
Absolutely.
But I loved it there. I had great friends and it was really cool. Do you like living in North Carolina?
No.
That's very honest. I didn't like living there either. I liked the people there, but I actually thought it was pretty desolate.
It is. It is. Yeah. See, and I'm in New York, I'm in LA, in Florida, you know, so I'm constantly traveling. So
I did read that you travel a lot. Where do you travel and what do you do when you're traveling? Do you travel for a reason or?
Acting.
Okay, well, there
usually
it is.
Working. Yeah.
Now, I'm going to get to the obvious part. You're like the James Bond of, you know, I don't want to compare you to a man. I should say James Bond is like the you, because he's fictional and you are real. So tell me about that. What do you were a police officer or you were...
18 years in law enforcement. Yeah, so 18 very long years in law enforcement. And I'm trained in absolutely any and everything you could possibly do.
Yeah. What are you trained in?
What am I trained in? SWAT team, weapons specialist, tactical driving, you name it, I can.
That's incredible.
Yeah.
That is so cool. Do you love doing it?
I love it.
Yeah.
Love it. Well, no, okay. That's twofold. Absolutely. Okay. I love doing that. Yeah. I love it even more now in the fictional world, in the acting world.
Yeah, of course.
I love, one, being a role model, mm-hmm. Because most women don't think they can do these things. You know, they see TV and it's really awesome and, oh, man. But, you know, it's real.
Of course.
To be in law enforcement today, no. I mean, it's a new time, new era, new people. It's scary.
But to you, what seems to be the scariest thing?
People, you see one or two events on the news and they think that, you know, that all law enforcement's bad,
mm-hmm.
you know, they think, mm-hmm. you know, anti this, you know, that and the other, there are nights that I didn't know if I was going to go home.
Yeah.
I mean, it's, people have zero regard for rules, for regulation, for anything. Yeah. And it's scary.
Yeah, I'm sure it is. Now, this is very... It's not that different from acting, because I can certainly see the two together, obviously.
Right.
You know, we love to watch action films. I watch them all day long. How did you manage to merge both of those? How did your acting, I guess, spirit begin?
I wanted to be an actor since I was a little kid. You know, and I started drama, I started, you know, acting.
What sparked that? What was the day when you thought, wow, I want to do that?
I don't know. I've just always been a performer, you know, always been the entertainer. You know, my family, you know, we play music, you know, just constantly involved in something. You know, and I've always loved film. You know, I was blown away, you know, just from a very, very young age going to the theater. First film I ever saw was E.T. Yeah, saw it in the theater
with
my parents. That was the first film, and it was just like,
yeah,
oh, gosh, you know, just the of that.
I remember that feeling. I know. Yeah. I know. Us film people, we know exactly the moment where we think, wow, you know, this is the greatest thing I've ever seen.
Yeah.
I felt that way, too, about... I saw that terrible movie, Treasure Island, with Gina Davis.
Yeah.
And it was so bad, but it was the first time that I had seen a woman, because I was very much a tomboy, and it was the first time I had seen a woman, you know, kick ass, because she was kicking ass. She was shooting guys, and she was basically the only woman in the film, and she was awesome, and the movie was terrible. But don't tell her I said that.
Never.
But it's, I definitely remember that moment when I thought, you know, if I can somehow live in that world, I would love to do that. So I totally get it. And that's funny that yours is E.T. That's great. What a great movie, right?
Right.
Do you have a favorite movie? Like, what's your favorite movie of all time?
Oh, wow. There are so many. You know, I'm a genre person, so mm-hmm. I love everything from Pulp Fiction to, oh, wow, Tomb Raider. You know, I love strong female films, you know, absolutely.
It's so cool. We were just watching Jessica Jones. And
Jessica Jones.
Yeah, and, like, not just Jessica Jones, because Jessica Jones has powers, but then
right.
I was thinking about Hogarth. Yeah, I have a passion for villains. I don't know if you are aware, but I love the villain. I love a good villain. I love a villain who has something you can understand about
right.
them. You know, they're not just
purpose.
Evil for the sake of being evil. They're right. they're evil. They're doing bad things because they're trying to do something good, and it just happens to be misguided. So that, you know, analyzing the character of Hogarth, and she has no power. The power that she has, she's earned. And the control that she has, she's earned. And I think that's pretty extraordinary, because that's what we as human beings actually do have. So you're watching a superhero show, but there are people who are not superheroes, but then again, they are. They are self-made superheroes.
Absolutely.
Yeah, so
villains.
I read in your bio that you co-wrote plays for your school.
I did.
That's pretty neat. Are you writing anything now?
I am not a writer.
No?
What am I writing?
So how did it work out when you were co-writing? Was this high school that you were co-writing stuff?
This started junior high up to high school, yes. And that portion of my creativity ended right then. I wish I could write. I would absolutely love it. But I'm more, you know, in front of the camera. Yeah. I do a little bit of directing and stuff too, so.
Cool. What? Tell me some things that we can maybe know about. I know that you were in the movie Vacation.
Vacation?
Yeah. Can you list some of those things that you were in so that we can watch you?
You can watch me. Yeah, absolutely. One of the biggest things that we're doing right now, this guy has an amazing following. He does fan films.
Mm-hmm.
And we just finished a Superman fan film. And it's about to, yeah, oh,
what are you doing in Superman? I can only imagine. I feel like you are a superhero.
This is shocking, but I play a deputy.
Mm.
And the scene, it's based in Smallville.
Okay.
And it focuses on the sheriff's department. So this is actually a pretty good role.
Okay.
Something happens within the department.
Okay.
And Smallville kind of gets...
And you're the deputy.
And I'm the deputy.
Okay.
Yeah. So,
cool. This whole thing started... Well, I don't... You know, I'm just making the assumption from what I've read that somebody was interested in making... some kind of film about a murder that you were pursuing?
Yes, I investigated a very high-profile murder mm-hmm. here in Fayetteville.
Are you a detective?
No, okay. I was just right place, right time.
Okay, that's, yeah, there you go.
You know, yes, I do have investigative experience, but I was not a detective at the time.
Okay.
And I was approached by Investigate Discovery.
Okay.
And they were starting, which one was that? Scorned. This was when Scorned. This was the very first episode of Scorned. So I was contacted by Investigate Discovery, and they're like, "Hey, you know, we're wanting to try this series." You know, they gave me the breakdown, and they said, "Are you interested? We want you to be our first show." And I was like, "Yeah," you know. And we got all that lined up, and. You know, I had my police car and pulled up on scene, and there was, you know, DP, and I mean, it was like skeleton crew. It was absolutely just like, oh my God, where's all the lights and the camera, you know, all this kind of stuff. And there was like three people standing there, you know.
Yeah.
But I tell you, the moment we started, that rekindled everything. And I said, you know what?
Yeah.
I have put this off my entire life, and this is this is what I want to do.
Why
So,
did you put it off, you think?
Well, I mean, you know about North Carolina.
I do. I do. I put off a lot of things in North Carolina.
You do.
Not to insult the state. I love the state of North Carolina, but it is not friendly for the arts that much.
It is not. It is not. And, you know, growing up in a very small, very, very small community. I mean, I'm surrounded by my family, you know, which is wonderful. You know, it's great. But you're limited, you know, things like that doesn't happen.
Yeah.
In small towns. Mm-hmm. I mean, you know, at the time, you know, we had Wilmington. Wilmington was booming.
Mm-hmm.
But it, I don't know, it just never happened. It was almost like the universe saying, you know, no, you need to be this person first. You need to get this experience. You need to do these things. And then I'll bring it back to you.
Okay.
You know, and pretty much that's what happened. You know, it was that desire when I was little.
Sure.
And then I was fortunate enough to get all that life experience.
Yeah.
You know, that, I mean, it's made me, it's made my career and, you know, definitely who I am. So very thankful for the way
it happened.
Yeah.
I have a quote that I wrote down that I really liked. And I want you to kind of, if you don't mind, elaborate. You said, "You can't pay for the training I have. If you line up 10 people with my experience, you'll have 10 men. I can actually do what they are trying to portray on screen."
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, obviously that says it all, but...
Right.
Is it incredibly frustrating for you to be hired to train a man to do something that you are already capable of doing, that you're willing to do?
Yes.
How do you handle that? Because, you know, us women, we handle that in different ways. You know, we all have our walls that we have to, every single day, we have to cross over those walls. And I have heard from other females in the law enforcement field that it's always a struggle, you know, that you're always kind of fighting and you're always kind of walking upstream, swimming upstream.
Right.
Is it the same in film? Like, do you find yourself thinking, I could very easily do this, why am I teaching a man to do it when I could just go in there and do it?
Well, I could just do it. Like, just here, move out of the way, let me show you
how this is done. So what do you do about that? Do you take action, or are you just kind of waiting your turn? Do you ever want to just say, hey, you know, I'm not going to teach them, hire me to do it, I'll do it? Do you ever think about that?
Of course, you know, that obviously that goes through your mind.
Yeah.
You know, 100%.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, then I try to stay true to the project. I understand that this is not my vision, you know, and I'm hired to do a job. So, you know, you kind of have to separate the two.
Okay.
I mean, obviously, you know, I can kick that door off a hinge way better than he can.
Of course, but... that's what I'm saying. And people love it because I know women love it. I love seeing a woman kick ass. I just do. It's plain and simple. You know, I love a good action film as much as the next person. But when, you know, I know that you like Atomic Blonde, and some people call you the Atomic Blonde.
The new one. Yeah.
Yeah, and it was so awesome to see her do her own stunts and do all that. And here you are, completely trained in all of these things. And why would they hire you to train a man? That must be incredibly frustrating.
Yeah, and you know, fortunately, a lot of the projects that I do work on, you know, where I'm doing some liaison work, I also have roles in.
Okay.
So I get, you know, I get to wear two hats on, you know, a lot of sets.
That's great.
So, you know, you kind of take it with the grain of salt that, hey, you know, I'm living my dream. I'm getting to do these things.
Do you work for, when you show up to set, do you find that it's very male dominant? Do you work also for a lot of women crews, or is it mostly men that you work with, since it's more action based?
It's mostly. Yeah, it's mostly men.
Yeah.
I would love, goodness, I would love nothing more than to work on a female.
Yeah,
office,
it's hard. It's very hard to change a man's mind. Where I find that when I'm on set and if I'm in charge, I don't feel like I'm above anyone. And if somebody has a suggestion, I'm very happy for them to suggest it to me, because I'm so overwhelmed with things that I feel sometimes I miss a lot. And sometimes there are ideas out there that I don't have, that other people have, but because I'm so busy trying to do a number of things at once, I don't have them. So I will say, if you ever find yourself, you know, I don't know that I would suggest this in a in a male-dominated set, because God knows you can't change their minds. But if you ever find yourself with a female director or something, just know that it's been my experience that we do like to be approached, and, you know, don't shout it on set or anything like that, but you just approach either the AD or somebody and you know, tell them, you know, I can't do this, or what if you save some money, kick this guy out, put me in there, and I'll do it, you know, twice as better.
Absolutely.
So do that. I want to encourage women to do that, because I have found that when I have women on set, especially women who are younger, in the early 20s and so on, they're afraid to say what they're thinking. And a lot of times, what they're thinking is much better than what I could have thought. And all you have to do is listen. I mean, even if you get rejected, who cares? You're not losing anything. It's just a suggestion.
Well, I want to suggest that. I want to suggest that to you for your next film, to kick that dude out.
Oh, yeah, no, I've kicked all of the dudes out. And I've absolutely thought about you and everything that you can do. So, you know, rest assured, I'm looking. That's why I'm doing this, because I'm looking for people like you to expand, you know, what we can do. Because we're always asking, you know, we're always asking for opportunities.
Oh, begging. So,
yeah, and it's exhausting, right? Because it's like have so much talent. You have so much that you can offer. And here you are begging to do something that is so natural to you. And I find it ridiculous, and I want it to stop. So I'm doing this so that we can all get to know each other, you know? Now we know each other. I met a lovely woman yesterday who does sound for the Oprah Winfrey Network. She works in Greenleaf and everything. But the thing is that women are so humble that they won't even tell you when they're amazing. You know, a man will tell you he's amazing
all day long
when he flips a book upside down and puts it on the bed and he says, look at my project. A woman can do, you know, evasive, what is it, evasive, what was the type of driving that you said you did? Tactical driving. Mm-hmm. And you can snipe and you can fight and yet here you are, like, it's no big deal, right? But if a man could do that, you would never stop hearing the end of it. And that's the thing. Now, I'm not saying we should brag about things, because I definitely don't like that. But I do think that we should make it known in our own, you know, in our own way. So I think it's very cool that you do that. So I'm just going to throw you some curveballs, because I like to do this thing where, like, I catch people off guard. Actually, you watch an interview, and everybody's always like, oh, it's so nice to do this, and it's so wonderful working with blah, blah, blah. And it's just like, you know, we all know the spiel, and, like, I'm sick of it. You know, like, I read interviews all day long, and I'm just like, can't they just say something honest or some truth? So I want you to just say whatever you want to say. Oh. There's no judgment here.
Danger.
We're all a team. It's not that I'm not going to ask you anything.
No, we're good.
I'm not going to set you up to fail. I just want to hear something honest, because I want people to start being honest.
And absolutely.
I try to be honest, and listen, I get a lot of crap for being honest a lot of the time, and I don't give two fucks, because, you know, I'm not going to pretend to be something I'm not. So here we go. What's your superpower?
My superpower?
Yeah.
Presence.
Well, that's a first. Presence. Are you very good at presence?
But that's what people tell me. You know, I have a presence. When I walk in the door,
yes.
Yeah. You know it.
Oh, wow.
You know?
That's very good presence. Yeah. Presence is fantastic.
Presence. Yes.
You can't put a price on that.
No.
You must be right. Have you ever done theater?
I attempted theater.
You like film theater.
I like the words cut and
and do it again. Let's try it again. Yeah, I like those too. I did same thing here. What's your spirit animal?
Oh, wow. Spirit animal. You're going to laugh. Adam Lambert. That is my spirit
animal. That's a wonderful spirit animal. Yeah, what is that? Why Adam Lambert?
Oh, man. He's just beautiful. I love his aura. He's just very round.
Did you see him on Drag Race?
Yes.
That was cool.
That was amazing.
I know. It was.
I have a t-shirt. A friend of mine is making a t-shirt, and it says, Adam Lambert is my spirit animal. So
Well, then you knew that right off the bat. Okay. If your celebrity crush was at a bar, and you were at a bar, and you were both single and available, and the circumstances were just right, how would you attempt to woo your favorite celebrity into a one-night stand?
Oh, wow. I don't know. I have that gift of gab. So, I could probably smooth my way in there.
Oh, yeah? What would you do?
I, you know, just something cheesy to break the ice and, you know, buy a couple of drinks.
My
and,
idea, my solution yeah. to get them drunk, right?
Very, no, romantic.
Romantic. Okay. Yeah, you're right, you're right. I'm doing it my way.
I'll try that next.
Yeah, yes, whatever.
Yeah.
Okay, okay.
That was great.
If you had to give up any aspect of your physical body, eyesight, hearing, sound, voice, any limbs, what would you give up and why?
Oh, wow. I would probably give up my right arm.
The right arm? Are you left-handed?
I'm left-handed.
Okay, good. If you're right-handed, I'd be like, oh, maybe she likes a challenge. I don't know. Your right arm, okay.
Yeah.
I think that must mean you're very good at kicking.
Yes, I can kick, yeah.
So. Okay, good. Good, that makes me feel safe. Let's see, what is your favorite book? Do you read?
I do.
It doesn't have to be fiction. Fiction, nonfiction. What's your favorite thing to read, like genre?
Favorite genre. Actually, I'm in school, so right now I read a lot of
textbooks.
Cool.
What are you in school for?
I'm in statistics right now. Forensic psychology.
This is
master's 3.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
That's crazy. You have three masters? What are your other two masters in?
Mental health therapy.
Okay.
And criminal justice / strategic intelligence. So.
Oh, look at you.
Yeah.
That's so cool.
So
you're basically built for film because you need all of those things to be able to understand, you know, the human condition and then fighting. And then now you're going for, what was the third one?
Forensic psychology.
Forensic psychology, okay.
Yeah.
Awesome.
I teach
That's
forensics.
So cool.
You know,
okay.
So this is just a little variation mm-hmm. of actual, you know, legal mm-hmm. forensics.
Do you ever, do you see yourself leaving North Carolina, moving someplace else?
Oh, yeah.
Is that something that's in the works, or
you know,
kind of waiting for
soon,
a sign? Or?
I mean, I would love for it, you know, to
yeah.
hurry up. Obviously,
yeah.
you know, I go where the job takes me.
Are you definitely set into acting? Do you ever think about making your own action film, for example?
I'd love
or
to.
Other kind of film?
Actually, I have two films that are here still. I had started working with a team in South Carolina, and they have so much going on right now. I'm just really looking for that right team. You know, I mean, it's both of them are so powerful. One of them is actually from my experience. You know, one of them is something that I mean, it created. Part of my career, so
yeah.
I'm real particular with who I want involved in that. You know, I really want to tell that story the way
cool.
it needs to be told. You know, and then
yeah.
The other one's really good too. So
mm-hmm.
just looking for the right.
Oh, just tell them. Just do it. Just tell them. No. I'm serious, and I don't mean to get all preachy because I don't like when people give me advice, and I don't like when people preach to me. But if you would allow me to say this. You can absolutely do it. You don't need a lot of money. You don't need a lot of resources. If you want to do it, you can do it. And believe me when I say that I want to watch it. I want to watch whatever it is that you have in your head. I want to watch it, and I'll buy it. I'll pay for it. You know, we all do. I think our community does, and we're willing to support each other. And now that we have resources like the internet, now everything is possible because now you can run a business in North Carolina and people in Europe will watch it. People
oh, yeah.
in Germany will watch it. People in Asia will watch it. So just do it, you know?
Oh, yeah.
Just do it.
You know, and my biggest thing, you know, with these guys is they're wanting, you know, to add this and change that and what if we did
mm-hmm.
this, you know, and so.
Forget them. Just if you hear something that sounds good to you, do it. But if it's nonsense, just forget about it.
Oh, yeah.
Just forget about it because you know what's best.
I do.
You do.
Yeah.
Women usually do. Women
Absolutely.
Usually know what's best.
I mean, I watch this film like daily in you know, in my
yeah.
mind, so I know.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. So you had an audition today. How'd it go?
I did. I had a co-star.
Uh-huh.
I had a stuffed cat. So.
Fantastic.
It's great. Yeah. So
yeah.
my co-star's name is Oscar.
Okay.
So, yeah, that was, yeah, my, you know, one of my agents is like, I need this today, and I'm like, what?
Yeah. You gotta do it.
Yeah. So I was like,
Do you audition a lot?
I do. I average several, up to 5-6 auditions a week. So
oh, that's a lot.
Yeah.
That's so
it's great. Knock on wood there. Yeah. Absolutely.
Is there a dream role that you are just dying to play? That's
just
like
to
inside
do.
You wanting to come out?
It would have to be a cross between the Jane Bond, Atomic Blonde, mm-hmm. Tomb Raider role.
Wow, that's my ultimate
female role
yeah.
there. And I would love the opportunity to do Captain Marvel.
That's so cool.
So
amazing. All right. Well, if you can't get it, write it and do it.
Yeah.
Just freaking do it.